Underwater photography is used all around the world to document the ocean and its amazing mysteries. This technique of photography started in 1856 when William Thomson first created a housing for his camera capable of being submerged in water. This first housing was a breakthrough into the unknown depths of the ocean. Today, there are many different types of housing and cameras that take the amazing pictures that we see in galleries, museums, textbooks, and documentaries. Not only has underwater photography changed the way we look at the ocean, but it has allowed humans to dig deeper and deeper into the depths and mysteries of the ocean. Being able to see what lies beneath the waves gives people a different view of the whole world. This breakthrough has revealed so many mysteries and has more waiting to be discovered. So, what exactly is underwater photography and how has it changed the world we see today? When did you start taking underwater photographs?
I think about 20 years ago when I started to really pursue the underwater stuff. Back then I was so worried about missing something above the surface because you're taking chances to get a unique shot, and looking back now, I'm really glad I did.
Underwater photography is used for many things. One of the main reasons we know so much about the ocean is because of all the photos and videos we have collected over the years and have been able to study. Even in the very depths of the ocean where people are not able to go down due to pressure, cameras are capable of scanning the bottom and finding new things that humans wouldn't be able to find without cameras.
Introduced to underwater photography?
I can't even remember, except a photographer named Aaron Chang had a photo of a girl bodyboarder duck diving a wave, and no one had ever seen that before. I was mesmerized.
Underwater photography is not only used for documenting and getting research, it is an art form that continues to find new ways to amaze and discover every day. New species that are found have bright colors and have interesting forms that catch the eye of all people. If no one had ever decided to explore the realm of underwater photography, then we wouldn't know the ocean the way we know it and understand it today. The species that we have discovered would still be a mystery, and only those brave enough to explore the depths of the ocean would know what it really looks like. What advice do you have for people interested in becoming an underwater photographer?
Well, for the underwater stuff, I think a housing just built to shoot underwater opposed to housings built to shoot surfing above the surface. If you're going to shoot both like me, well then get a CMT housing and you can still shoot to around 20 feet under and kill it above the surface.
Underwater photographers have a much bigger challenge taking pictures because the many key factors of photo taking are missing when going into the depths. Light is almost completely gone at 200 meters in the twilight zone. This dim light only captures grainy and blue-green photos. At 1,000 meters in the midnight zone, there's absolutely no light. And of course, the twilight and midnight zones are the most unknown parts of the world. Underwater photographers are always looking to capture pictures of new species of fish and other underwater creatures, but with this light restriction, they are not able to explore beyond sea level without natural light.
What are some challenges and risks you take to take pictures in the ocean?
You really need to be physically prepared, and if you're taking chances, you need to be mentally prepared also. Swim a lot and get used to being out for hours at a time. Then practice swimming in and out when the surf gets a bit bigger. You need to work up to it.
In 1893, a breakthrough was made. Louis Boutain, a photographer, realized his restrictions of light in little depths of water. He realized that the rays of the sun shone straight down into the water and not sideways or all around, which compromised the amount of exposure in the shots. So, Boutain created an underwater flash device that he was able to use to get the picture that he wanted. His flash device was an alcohol lamp in an oxygen-filled barrel over which a puff of magnesium was sent to trigger a flash. This device was a one-time use. Over the years, the underwater flash has advanced more and more. Today, a technique called fill-in flash is used in most underwater photos. Fill-in flash is a technique that paints in the missing colors and contrasts of the photos. Even in sea level, fill-in flash is mostly used. Another thing that the photographers have to keep in mind is the temperature and saltiness of the water. In warmer waters, the water is much bluer, whereas in colder waters, the water is green. What are some of the essential items you always use when taking underwater photographs?
Really, the only essential items I use are a mask, a snorkel, and a set of fins. I usually use my 8 to 15 millimeter lens, and I like my 1DX body. All Canon equipment, of course.
Underwater photography has changed the way that we know the ocean. And even what we do know doesn't compare to what we haven't discovered yet. If we had never decided that the ocean is a mysterious place filled with amazing plants and animals, our ability to know what these plants and animals really look like would not be what it is. With all of the pollution and destruction that most of the ocean is undergoing today, most humans have learned that we must know to respect and preserve the ocean and understand its true beauty. And that's the reason underwater photography has changed the way we see the world.